Okie dokie. Whoop. Hi, everybody, and back on once again in time for some Gems of War. And today, I kind of overslept. So, like, I laid down at my usual 4 a.m. Woke back up at, like, 9 a.m. So, just like, just for some odd reason, and just, I'll just go ahead and lay down for, like, another hour or two. Plop. Next thing you know, I woke back up again and looked at the clock. I was like, oh, shit, 12:30. Like, I wasn't expecting to lay down that long, so I was kind of hoping for something like yesterday, where I think I started my stream, like, 11 a.m. So I was kind of hoping for something like that, but nope. So here it is, 1 p.m. right now, so, but like I said, I'm putting it in quotation marks, I overslept. I mean, my default time is 2:30 p.m., but even then, even with what I got right now, I'm still early, but anyway. But yeah, just gonna be, it's a brand spanking new week, so just gonna be fairly busy doing dailies, weeklies, probably trying to get my PvP tier to tier 1. Let's see, what else? And then, once again, I'm gonna have to use my tablet, my big old junky clunky tablet, because the boys down there at Twitch decided to screw me over on chat space and decided to add a bunch of useless buttons down here at the bottom, so now I have like very little space to work with. So if the same thing that happened yesterday happens today, where I had a bunch of people on here chatting it up and stuff, I'm probably gonna miss a bunch of stuff on here because I can't hardly see anything. And that's not good. But I still have to keep this on tap, though, because, again, my tablet is a piece of junk. So, I mean, yesterday, too, I was on the Twitch app, you know, getting it all set up, and all of a sudden, the thing just rebooted, just out of the blue. So, I won't be surprised if it happened again. But I guess while I'm here, let me do something real quick. Got a problem. Looks like I might have to use my cell phone after all. Looks like my tablet's frozen solid. Yup. So, good thing I checked. Okay, so Looks like I'm gonna have to work on that throughout the stream, because once again I've gotta have more chat space than just that. So this time around I'm having some red kidney beans with barbecue sauce. And then I'm gonna have to go up and get it real quick. I'll be a moment. Yep, it reset. So, a few days ago, when I went grocery shopping, I was trying to buy some chocolate almond milk. Now, they were completely out of the kind I normally get, so I gotta settle for this stuff, Fairlife. It's like lactose free. I took a sip of it. I'm not a fan of it. It tastes actually too chocolatey. Like, yeah, like totally artificially flavored. Okay. Alright, I'll be back. But yeah, it's like they sugared the living hell out of it. So And then, here, let me fix it. Let me fix it. Yeah. But anyway, yeah. This is kind of, it's technically classified as dungeon synth. This music here. I almost want to call it a storytelling synth. Or, let me phrase that, comfy synth. There we go. That's the word, comfy synth. So yeah, Toad Folk, Tales Under the Yoke. They actually have a... I don't want to say trilogy. I think they have more than three albums. But yeah, it's like a long-running album series. There's like the Toad King, the Toad Kingdom. But yeah, there's more than one of these kind of albums though. But this one here is probably my favorite because, yeah, you'll find out as you listen to it. Most likely I'll probably have to turn that down a bit. Let's go back in here. Oh, not the one. That wasn't it. Part of time I used to know the hotkey for the volume on this thing. There it is. Which team is better? I don't know, I hadn't gotten there yet. Basically, I'm still setting up my stream. Said earlier, I gotta get my tablet up and running. So once already, it actually decided to reboot on me. Seems I got a glitchy mouse. Ain't gonna be that one. Rematches. Rematches. Yeah, I am not a fan of this milk. Guess my tab is still trying to figure out what it wants to do. There we go. Okay. Connected, no internet. The hell? There we go, there we go. Now it's connected. This is why this is my main team right here. Gotta have that cleanse. Great matches. Oh yeah. Yuck. It's like the stuff's even more chocolatey than the chocolate almond milk that I normally get. Like I said, they sweeten the living hell out of that. Thank you.
What a pity. Sighed a tired toad in a shabby green robe. He was staring at the once beautiful mushroom house, masterfully carved by himself a long time ago. But now it was just an old, crooked building with pale moss and thick spider web covering every curve and window. The entrance with a round oaken door almost collapsed, and a part of the cap roof fell off. Last pair of winters were obviously too harsh, even for such a carefully planned architecture. It was one of the first projects that he mastered all by himself.
My tablet works, but there's going to be a long delay on it, so let me go on my Twitch description.
After 20 years of honest hard work, he was invited to plan a project of the Royal Castle, together with a few more famous carvers from the far swamps. It is hard to describe what a huge honor it was for him, and as he saw his name, Brog the Builder, woven with a golden thread amongst others on the huge royal carpet decorating the main castle hall, he stood there, dazed with a clear thought. This is it. This is the biggest creation of my life.
I'm still going to keep I'll keep this close by, because I still don't trust my tablet right now. Like I said, it froze once, and it rebooted all of a sudden on me, so,
it was an ordinary house for a simple toad family, but it was where everything started. Well, muttered Brog the Builder to himself, waking up from his own thoughts. This family needs a new home anyway, and I will do my best to create the most beautiful thing in a simple way I've ever made before.
Well, good way to start. Leprechaun. I could probably go on with just this team here. Let me check my chat real quick. Looks like I'm gonna have to go on the forums, or probably gonna have to do a Google search to try to find out which is a more valuable wrath or to spawn. One would think that they're the same point value, but that's not always the case. And I gotta turn this down. Wrath. Bane of Mercy? Hang on, let me look at that. No, actually I need to go after it. Okay. No, Bane of Mercy.
Quite rustling in the thick swamp bushes got attention for the little toad, playing with his friend in the late summer evening. Ash, what was that? I didn't hear anything, but it could be fish or just the bees. No, no, replied the first toad, worried. There is surely something bigger than a fish, and it moves above the water. In that moment, a sharp boat's edge appeared out of the plant's thickness.
So, once again, back to the board.
A toad was sitting on that boat, made of a dried, oiled water lily, with two big sacks on each side of it. Focused on his own thoughts, he did not smile. Yet, The children could say that he was a friendly creature. Good evening, little folks, said the bonito. I hope I did not disturb your peaceful game. I am just passing by to see if the south corner of the swamp already has something to offer. What is it the swamp can offer you? Asked one of the little toads with undisguised interest. The finest berries in all the kingdom, of course. Now, have a good evening, little ones. I've got no time to waste. With these words, he made two strong pushes with his beautiful, lightweight paddle and disappeared behind the low willow branches. Who was that? Asked the youngest toad. That was old Bob, the berry belly, said the other.
Oh, Bob, the berry belly.
My granny told me stories about him and his craft. He doesn't like company, but as far as I know, every cure potion we've got for winter is made out of these rare berries and vines. Oh, it is getting late. Let's get back home before everyone starts to worry about us. I want to be a boat toad too when I grow up.
I want to be a boat toad too.
The youngest toad inspired, catching up with his friend.
Whoever the voice actor is for this really needs a fucking raise, man. Boy, did they ever pick a gem. Listen up. Let me double check again. Yeah, Man of Mercy is the best you can get. Itself right now.
Still gotta keep checking my tablet. Okay. Tablet seems to be working at the moment. Hoping that badge is gonna be enough to carry me through on this. Yeah, barely. To get the Weaver going. Katara. The name. Yeah, I only heard the name, so that'd be a new one to me. That's just barely not enough. But I stated it in my Twitch description. I have to use my tablet, and from the testing out that I've been doing of it, there's gonna be a fairly long delay on it. So, like, longer than the usual 20 seconds.
It was a dark winter night, and the wind was howling like a thousand beasts. For 3 days, a hunter had been chasing a peculiar creature, a fairy bug of the great bulk. It was such a rare thing to come across this bug that its shadowed nature started to grow over with dozens of strange stories and myths. Some believed that it was a witch trapped in a body of an insect. The others thought that it could make your deepest dreams come true. Bart himself heard a lot of unbelievable stories like that, but did not believe in them, to be honest. The only thing he learned from his father is that it was a very rare creature with some half-magical properties, and that its meat could feed a few toad families for at least a month long. So with full dedication, he was chasing the bug over the snow hills and curly dark roots sticking above the frozen ground. When the hunter grew weary after hours of his run, he decided to make
a
bonfire beneath an old oak tree to warm up his tired bones. He dozed off on a soft bed of moss suddenly, a truly fairy creature appeared in front of him, floating behind the flames. "I know what you want, Hunter," whispered the bug, "and you have a choice. You can try to kill me and bring me back to your swamp, to the joy of your folk. Or you can make your bow sing the most beautiful song. And if my heart sings to it as well, I will make one dearest dream of yours come true." The hunter kept silence for a while.
Okay, so it's
took out his bow.
I started this stream later than I wanted to. So the way it's looking right now, I don't think there's gonna be a second break, but we'll see as the stream progresses.
When the song was finished, the bug said, "Tell me, Hunter, what is it you wish?" "I wish to feed everyone in my swamp so that no one would starve in this dark winter." "I will do as you wish, Hunter," replied the fairy bug, and with a flash of blue light, in the clear night sky, full of shimmering stars.
Pinball.
At least 100
joyful pinball.
Toads
that,
met the hunter that night.
Note the quick response. But, I'm kind of burnt out on pinball right now.
Was full of food of
so I just not really wanting to play it for, like, long periods. And then secondly, my computer basically needs to be retired. So, Pinball FX 3 crashes half the time, or I should say, at least half the time. The DX11 version of Pinball Arcade also crashes, leaving my only real option being the DX9 version and Zachariah Pinball. Two versions I don't really care for, so it's probably one of the reasons why I play Gems of War so much now, because it's stable, it doesn't crash on my computer, so. sure that's gonna be enough. Yeah. Fucking really?
Winter's coming, little fellow, and every song is getting mellow. The folks are gathered round the hearth to talk and think about their path. Before we see the day, the time is right to hear a tale. One tale or two of winds and fires to soothe adventurous desire.
Well, so much for that.
A tale of simple folks and...
Kind of need to get life and death going.
Ancient sorceries and rings. For every taste, I'll find a word about a bug, about a toad. Now listen, Bog and Dungeon Dweller. My name is Krog, the Storyteller. I'm waiting, friend. This is your turn. To choose a tale that keeps us warm.
So, no bronze or perps. Got enough. It's not enough. Still not enough. Damn. Well, so far I'm in first place, so... Should be able to leave it just the way it is. So this is gonna be David Ricci, the occult summoner. But probably not gonna have it on that long. Take them. So, Back up. Yeah, I'll probably mostly use this team, just at least to get to tier level 1, just not really in the mood to fuck around. Debuff the right one. still a good game. Even though this, technically this game isn't my first choice. I mean, it's still a good, still worth playing. Yeah. I mean, there's microtransactions on here, but they're not as required as they are on Candy Crush. Speaking of that, campaign. Yeah, you gotta kill four of them. If you only had to kill one Queen of Sin, I'd do it, but not four of them. Let's bring out the ship. There goes one. Yep. I call them the shit birds for a reason. They can't do shit. Yep, guess even a team like that is too much for my poor sweet shitbirds. So, hell? Why didn't that damage him? Or unless he was shielded. There you go. It's a great team to start with over here on the right. I think I've talked about this in one of my recent streams. Complete the storyline in the Erskaya Kingdom, And then, whatever you gotta do to get 250 wins with the Sentinel class, and you'll get this. Get Rowayne. Complete the story in, Forest of Thorns, I believe. Leprechaun, I think you have to get lucky with this guy. And, opening chests. Mirage Queen. I think you have to unlock all the kingdoms in the overworld in order to access the underworld, I think. And then, unlock a kingdom called Sunken Fleet, complete the quest there. They just, you're gonna have to spend a lot of shards until you get this, the Mirage Queen. But yeah, great starter team right here. I think you have to get the dragon something or another class to 250 wins. I could save you losing this one. And right off the bat, someone submerged. About to lose my leprechaun. Oh, got super lucky there. Three matches. There we go. Matches. Okay. So, call it a good on that album. Okay, played this yesterday. All right, here we go. Fix this though. So yeah. This is a Gadfly and their Apernic album. No, I'm checking right now. Close enough. Top guy, please. Top guy, free matches. Top guy. Top guy. Real shitty RNG going on right now. Top guy. Top guy. Luckily, I beat him. Well, let's bring out the shitbirds again. Maybe. Maybe they'll be able to beat or at least survive him. Hey, it just hit me. He doesn't even have all the traits on him. Yeah, no reason I shouldn't be able to beat these guys now. This is what I call a pity win right here. Didn't have all the traits on his firebombs. Yeah. Maybe we'll be able to beat these guys too. I mean, these guys don't attack, so this is basically our treasure group. Oh, no search for Joe. Another pity win for the shipbirds. Alright, so... Damn, two quintessence on your butt. No. definitely gotta go back to my main. No way Shipbirth can be able to take down this group. Not when they're struggling against treasure groups, no. Oh, this crap. Yeah. They gotta explode gems at the start of battle. This actually would be doable, but the number's kind of misleading. It doesn't mean two single battles, it means 2 days of dungeons, so yeah. I can get Yellow Slayer a lot faster than that. Excuse me. I don't really want to say yucky as much as maybe rich, but like I said, they oversweeten the stuff. Three matches. Matches. Get them while they're hot. I don't get to play today. Should have just used the ship parts instead. I gotta get out of the firestorm. Matches. Luckily, he only got one off. Three matches. Oh no, he's gonna get a bunch of them. Oh damn, Rosa kicked in. another free one for the shitbirds. If I can remember to, I'm gonna have to go on this guy's profile and give him a helpful, because, like I said, it's about all this team can handle. And here's one of the reasons why. This is like my main team, but worse. But, the shipwrecks becomes viable at level 70 when you can, explode yellow gems when matching 4 or more. And yeah, this is my defense team. See it happening. Gotta last. Still have to blow the fucking board again, but like I said, I don't have full faith and trust in this team, and it looks like we're gonna lose. Oh, got lucky. Yep, still gonna lose, but it's gotta be all blue with this team. Gotta be all blue. Gotta be all blue. Frozen. So, kind of got fuckled on the RNG. Here we go. Frozen. So, one stinking hit point. Like, fucking really. all blues or yellows. Don't see it. Don't see it. And I probably won't get my surge. No, I think I did. Probably won't get my surge. Ooh, how about that? Miracle, miracles, I got it.
God fucking damn it!
This is not the way I want it to go. Definitely. So, I think we're too late. Well, at least the queen got debuffed. Uh-uh. That's the shit you don't want right there. Let's say, should be enough. PvP needs a filter option. Sure would love to filter out the elementalist teams. And then oh. Top guy. Top guy. Top guy, there we go. Should be smooth sailing from here. Should. Shit for green gems. So, let's give them some free matches. Oh, not lucky. And we have a firestorm too. Or it's a dust storm now, but. Still want to do a few more matches, try to eke out a few more wins. The goal being trying to at least get 2,000. Technically, I think you only need 1,800 of these points to get tier 1, but I also have to factor in all the losses that I'm gonna get. So, because I have been knocked down to like tier 2 or tier 3 because of all the losses I'll sustain. So, 1,800 ain't enough, so I'd like to get it to at least 2,000. Oh! Think you need to put a class in there, buddy. Rematches. Rematches.
Here we go.
Okay, might be going on out of limb, but maybe the shitbirds can handle this group? Maybe? I don't know. Those cows, they're pretty threatening. Shitbirds. Try again. But I guess, since I'm here, this is a ball. You could also probably call this they call it a Nimbus ball. We could also call it a backfiring ball. Like I said, it kind of does the same shit that my main team does, like Queen Beatrix and Minoxia. Oftentimes you're handing your opponent free matches. The problem with this though is the blue gems are of absolutely no use to my team at all. Nobody on my team uses blue, so it's basically dead weight. The only upside to this item is it silences the top guy, but that's all it does. It silences just the top guy. I have no control over where it goes otherwise. Now, there was another item, I can't remember the name of it. It explodes all yellow gems. Basically, it's a half a dozen of the other weapon. Like I said, it's more effective because it blows up all the yellows. So it doesn't create useless blue gems or anything, but I don't think it does anything else, though. So we're over 2,000. I can do that. Wrong one. Doing a quick sample battle. So there's Nimbus Bow. Yeah, Staff of Storms was the other one. Yeah, explode 28 gems. They It creates a light storm too, I just noticed that, but with my Stormcaller class, it already does that, so it's just a redundant ability. Yeah, that's it. It's a mixture of blue and yellow. It isn't like the Queen Bee creates exactly 9 green and exactly 9 brown. So you know what you're gonna get out of that. Vinoxia, same thing. Exactly 9 green, exactly 9 blue. And then my team can use green and blue. My team can use green and brown. So, but again, let me bring up the shit birds again. Again, my shipbirds team has no use for blue, so dead weight. The most you can do is make a 4 match and yeah, there it is. So that's about it. Tier stuff, but again, the team this is one of the basically the team doesn't really become viable until you get level 70 on this, so that's also why you'll often see me despite the fact that they're not very useful in PvP, but me still doing PvP with this team anyway. Like I said. Mouse is glitching. Okay, so gonna go ahead and break off for about 5-10 minutes or so. And wait, whoa, let me back up. Okay. So get that going. Oh, and this is Just Cause 2, I believe. Anyway, I'll be back. have some Wawa. And some red grapes.
Don't take no passengers.
Have some chicken breast with teriyaki sauce. I want to say that's a bug exploit.
Listen, Zelda. I need your help urgently. One of my men has infiltrated the government customs operations for some time, but they're on. He will have to leave the country quite quickly. Can you please pick him up and bring him to an airstrip, where we have arranged to have him flown out?
Yeah, I don't think that was supposed to work. How you doing, dude? Okay, and then, I'm gonna go ahead and put the video on ice. If I do take a second break, I'll just go ahead and pick up where I left off on that. But yeah, I've gotta get back going on the game. I did both of the, completed both the challenges on these.
Thank you.
it's not worth the 1 XP. All aboard, and I didn't get anything out of that. In case anyone's curious, the lead singer of this band is Persian. Everybody else in the band are all Canadian. She's bilingual, but I think the majority of this album is sung in Persian, either Persian or Farsi, one of those. Matches. One stinking hit points.
Thank you.
the mattress. Hey, 40% kicked in. Three matches. Fuck! I think I've had Zolgoth battles that went quicker and smoother than this. Okay, stop it right here. The rest of the album for the next 10 minutes, this is all it's gonna be. So, off to the next one. And this one here I'm definitely gonna have to fix. So, this is gonna be Schempty. Can't remember the name of the album off the top of my head. But I think Guitaro would definitely like this kind of music. It's, I guess you could call it Arabian Dungeon Synth. Let me look real quick. Yeah, Schempty, Sunrise on the Old Kingdom. I guess my colon decided just now. So I gotta run to the bathroom real fast. I'll be back. to be a while. Session. Alright, gotta turn it on a little bit. I guess while I'm here, let me check the matches. I think I'll do that one. Thank you. So I guess the goal is to get my winter imps to where they're gonna deal 300 damage. That. Still enough. Bogey humbucker. Yeah, I basically have to stay for this. Of course. Guess what? Here come the skulls. That should do it. There we go. Matches. All Top guy. Here we go. Three matches. Luckily, he'll. I'm babbling right now. Brown, so let's re-rack that. They got summoning in this one. Oh! No Dust Devils. So... Where's that at? Actually, this might actually be one of the rare chances where the Shipbirds might actually be useful here. Especially if you're in the left, especially if you're going slow in the left lane. You need to get the hell out of there. It's one of my pet peeves when driving. Thank you. Never mind, I got it. You have to do four of them. Okay, so we got summoning shit. Oh, can't have that. My surge. Oh, excuse me. Okay. Too much of a good thing, I guess? Yeah. It was like a 45-minute album, so it was just gonna continue on and on and on. Thank you, Guitaro. And this one here, most certainly gonna have to fix. Floris? Or Yoris? It's there. Into the Unknown album. Okay, so this is Hattis, and it's there, Into the Unknown album. Yeah, pretty much. You only gotta complete the driver's test once. Thank you. Yeah, here in this country, at least in my neck of the woods, you only have to complete your driver's license test once. You're only gonna get tested on your driving skills one time. So, gonna have to use the shitbirds for this one. Gonna get my surge. One shot. Might be a short album. It's awfully repetitious. Try that again. Retarded, Joe. Well, that didn't last long. Gonna have to do more than just that. Lactus, or whatever their name is. Yeah, Screw might like this one. maybe.
Nope.
Not enough. Green and brown, please. Is entangled. So, once again, I gotta switch. I might have that. Yeah, I think that's the meteor banner. No, gate banner.
Retard! What the fuck?
Not what I had in mind. Green and brown. I guess it was enough. Okay. I had to consider that Infernal King too. He has like a 25% chance of reviving after death. Entangle fell off, so... God damn! Maybe? Bad time for this to happen. Ah, click. Gonna get my surge. She's immune to entangle, so we'll take her off. Fuck you, bitch. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, he's not immune to he's not immune to entangle. Of course, I could have done that earlier. Kind of hard to focus when you're pissed off. Fucking gnomes in a row. Gotta love it. A leaf storm with no leaves. And a tangle fell off. Said earlier than I want to. Oh, didn't help. Let's see if I can get something better. Got lucky at the last moment. Wrong one. There we go. Actually, no. Half the team's yellows. Just stay the course, stick with Menotites. Yeah, I'm at a level now where it might just be too much for the ship birds to handle, and we need some green and browns, please. Green and brown, please. One stinking mana short. Here we go. Tangle fell off of him anyway. He's dead. Ooh, got lucky. Got a rearrange out of it. And
Retard! What the fuck?
Missed the poor match. Must have been a spirit jump someplace and yeah, I have to do the skull damage. Nothing I can do. So someone gonna die. Or maybe not. Alright, gonna have to bring out the main for this. Apparently, this is just too much for any of my other teams to handle. It's like I should've... I just brought up the shipbirds instead. Roseanne. Still not enough.
Thank you.
cop.
Well, they're on my greens. Didn't quite work. That should. Nope. So, let's bring out the rock band. Reract it. Let's see if I can get something better. Oh, still not enough. So. Oh, here we go. Have some magic, please. For Joe. Actually, you know what? This might be too big of an ask for this team, but I'll go ahead and bring them out anyway. Oh, didn't get my surge. About that, it's still my turn. Usually it isn't, but like I said, the blue gems that this creates are of no use to this team. So like I said, it's a lot of dead weight. Fell off. Well, how about that? We actually won one. So I got 3-3 matches. Top guy's not entangled. This might be enough. Yep. Let's have some greens and browns, please. Take that. Won't take that, though. Gotta get an entangle on the top guy, that'll work. Oh, that works even better. Maybe. Cool. Nope, still the same album. And also, the way it's looking right now, probably gonna be shutting down fairly soon, too. When he gets pulled to the top, because when Ketris gets pulled to the top, it's pretty much gonna shut down the two ferocities. Plus, at this level, this team here, wrong one. Controller keeps glitching. Basically, this team has a one-time use. They're gonna. Otherwise, if I can't take out the team with one shot of all my abilities, that means I gotta go clucking for blue and brown matches again in order to get this up and running. So, so, I'd end up, well, half the team's yellow, so something else I keep forgetting to mention, too. These guys deal double damage against yellow targets, but like I said, half the opposing team is yellow, so maybe these guys have a chance. This is one of the reasons I call them the shitbirds. Well, how about that? Stop, click, or I should say move. Still got a ways to go. Work. I think maybe after this battle, or basically when I complete. Once I complete these challenges here, I'll probably end up calling it a sesh. Kind of stumbling with English right now. Entangled fell off, which means I. Maybe not. Didn't really help. Would have been a four match, but 140. He's dead. Nope, got lucky. Jump. Excuse me. So yeah, looks like I did it. Otherwise, that's going to do it for me, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and call it good. I got to get going on my blog post. I got to get that all typed up and posted up. So, and I definitely got grocery shop, but I got to get taken care of. Yeah, like I said, I'm there's stuff I'm completely out of. I couldn't get because the store didn't have it at the time. So, I got to go get it now. The chocolate milk being one of them, so. Still gonna have a fairly busy evening, but otherwise, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that, and I should be on again tomorrow. Once again, my default time is 2:30 p.m. U.S. Central, if not earlier. So, but yeah, but until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time.